Esteemed guests, honorable panelists, worthy principal officers, ladies and gentlemen, I, Amara Hashmi, welcome you to the two-day international workshop on assessment in e-learning and quality assurance challenges in collaboration with the Commonwealth of Learning Canada, hosted by Virtual University of Pakistan.
Now we will move further for our session. I'm going to request my second respectable speaker for today's session, Dr. Aisha Mahmood, who is currently working at the Department of STEM Education at the University of Education, Lahore, as Assistant Professor, Education. Dr. Aisha is a consultant of engineering education research and practice and a certified practitioner and trainer of TRIZ. Dr. Aisha has also been involved in several educational workshops and teaching training at the regional, national, and international levels. We all are fortunate to have her with us, and she will deliver a talk on emerging assessment trends in e-learning, part one. Ma'am, I welcome you all on behalf of Virtual University of Pakistan. Please proceed for your presentation. Thank you.
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. Assalamu alaikum and very good morning to all the participants who are sitting here and the participants online. And I'm really grateful to the rector Dr. Bhatti and Dr. Naveed Malik to giving me the chance to share my knowledge and some of the practical tips which I have been using over the years with all of you. So as you know that the topic is related to the emerging assessment trends in e-learning. So let me start with activating some of your prior knowledge. Okay, before that, I have to share the agenda. So we'll be discussing about what is educational goal and what are the teaching and learning circles, what is educational assessment, what are the purposes of assessment, what is meant by assessment for, as, and of learning, and what are the emerging assessment trends. And then we'll be learning some of the emerging trends as well. I really like this statement shared by Stephen Covey. He said, to begin with the end in mind means to start with a clear understanding of your destination. It means to know where you are going so that you better understand where you are now, so that the steps you take are always in the right direction. So here he has mentioned two important things. One is the direction and one is knowing your destination. And that will basically highlight towards where you are right now. So this is first activity. This is an activity which is called Think, Pair, Share. So as a teacher, what do you want to achieve in teaching? So I'm giving you 1 minute to just think about it and then share your views with the person sitting next to you. So just 1 minute to share that. And the participants who are online, I would request you to share in the chat box or in the WhatsApp group. What do you want to achieve in teaching? Give yourself a minute to think and then share. Now you can share your answers in the chat box. And if anyone sitting here wants to share anything, they can share here. Anyone who wants to share from the audience sitting here? Okay, let's see. What do we really want out of our teaching? So we'll be targeting to achieve certain graduate attributes. Those are categorized in three groups. One is called knowledge. That is the facts that your students know and concepts that they understand. And the second is skills that they need to use in managing and applying those concepts and facts and figures, along with the 21st century skills. And the third one is the attitudes. And that is the most neglected one, because that dictates the goals towards which their skills and knowledge will be directed. And along with that, we need to inculcate intrapersonal competencies in our students. Okay, just to give you an idea about what kind of learning skills we need to impart, you can see that there are four categories in front of you. One is creativity and innovation skills. The second group is critical thinking and problem solving skills. Those are cognitive skills. Those we need to impart in our students. The third one is interpersonal skills. Those are how do they communicate, how do they collaborate. And the fourth one is their literacy about information, their digital literacy and their computer literacy. So these are the four main chunks that is being needed by the 21st century, 21st century requirement. So one more thing which I need to add, that in attitudes, while we were developing those attitudes, there is a whole bunch of intrapersonal skills that we need to impart, that we need to develop in our students. Just think about those skills, and then I'll show you some of them. Take a second to think, what kind of intrapersonal skills do I want my students to have? Okay, the first and the foremost is the mindset. So there is a research that if a student has been groomed as having a growth mindset, they can get succeeded in their professional life. And there is a second very important attribute that can, you can say the success indicator is great. Great means passion and perseverance for the long-term goal. Not for the short-term goal, means not for the grades, it's for the long-term goal. And then learning agility, how fast they adapt into the situation they have been into. And then the social responsibility. There comes intellectual interest, the curiosity, metacognition ability. So do they have the ability to reflect back? Do they know how to think about their own thinking? And then intuitiveness, self-directedness. And thus comes the vision that they're going to follow for the rest of their life. So let me just help you to zoom out and see how these graduate attributes fit into the whole curriculum design. As you can see, our graduate attributes that need to be designed are not isolated with the system. So there is a curriculum design that is targeting to the purpose of the program, the resources, teaching and learning methods, the structure of the program, and thus contributing to developing those attributes in our graduates. Okay, let's just review what is teaching circle. All of you know that we have to divide the teaching circle into three main phases. One is before the teaching, then during the teaching, and then after the teaching. So one is planning, the other is implementation, and the last one is evaluating. And that is again in circle with the planning. So next time you will teach, you will get the information out of your this circle, and then you will improve yourself. Well, what is happening at the learner's end? Let me just show you that. Starting with engaging your students means you have to activate their prior knowledge. You have to pique their curiosity for the subject matter. You have to then give them enough opportunities to explore what is there in the content, what is there on the internet, what is related to the concept, how they can use it. And then you need to give them an opportunity to explain what they have learned and demonstrate what they have achieved out of that whole process. And then they will extend their knowledge to a level where they can create new knowledge. And then definitely you should give a chance to the students to evaluate their learning. Every time you ask them, what have you learned at the end of your class? And try to sum up what they have learned. So again, this is a very cyclic process. And you can see that this process goes on and on and on. Okay, these are some of the very, favorite definitions of assessment for me. So for me, assessment is that helps you to distinguish between teaching and learning. It also refers to a wide variety of methods and tools that educators use to evaluate, to measure, and to document the academic readiness, learning progress, skill acquisition, or educational needs of a student. Another definition: defensible interpretations and decisions based on defensible information or collection of information about the valued content. Okay, moving forward, there are 5 levels of assessment. Very core level is where we all are very concerned about, like assessing our individual students' learning within a course. And then moving forward, level 2 is assessing individual students' learning across the courses. And the third level is assessing the courses, not the student, but the courses overall. And then assessing the programs, and that leads to assessing the institution. Here we are more concerned about the very first and the core level, that is assessing individual student learning within a course. So fundamentals that you need to ask to yourself: why we have to learn about assessment? Because it helps you to learn about your students, so that your students, you can help them to learn. You can help your students to determine whether or not they understand the course material or not. And you also have to learn it because you need to help your students to motivate, to get motivated for the next upcoming content. And there are 5 principles of quality assessment, as you can see. Practicality. So you have to see how practical your assessment is, how reliable it is and valid it is, how authentic your assessment is, and are you concerned with the washback effect? Have you ever heard of this washback effect? That your students are preparing for exams just to attempt the exams. Your assessment should not be for the sake of assessment. It should be meant for learning. So washback effect is the effect of testing on teaching and learning that can be positive, that can be negative. And you need to be aware of the negative washback effect. So you always focus on the positive one. So the research categorizes the assessment into 3 categories. One is for improvement. That should help teacher to improve. That should help student to improve. The second main category is for accountability. That is there to evaluate and certify a student, plus to evaluate and qualify our schools and teachers. And the third main category, which we all should know, is irrelevance. So please make sure the assessment you are creating or developing or conducting should not be rejected because it is not helping students or helping you to improve or to make you accountable. So it should be ignored because it is not needed. So rethinking about the classroom assessment with purpose in mind, I can split down the 2 main, the first 2, the purposes which we discussed in the previous slide, into further 3 categories, subcategories. One is assessment for learning. That is mostly the formative assessment. That you have to see whether your students are learning or not. So it is meant for improvement. The second, which is a new, maybe for some of you, is assessment as learning. So how to develop an assessment during which your students are learning? And then assessment of learning, that is mostly your summative assessment. So research shows that all of these three purposes should be combined in a single assessment plan. So I would help you to develop that in your future courses. So before actually going into the formative and summative analysis and comparison, let me just, you know, focus onto this category, which is assessment as learning. That is focusing on your students, That is helping them to initiate the process of metacognition. So you need to make them reflective of what they have learned, how they have learned, what are the aha moments, what are the moments then when they feel stuck. So you are monitoring their progress, you are giving them feedback to make adjustments, you are empowering your students and independent learners. So students are personally monitoring what they are learning and use what they have discovered from monitoring to make adjustment in the way of learning. They adapt to the new situations and even make changes in their metacognitive ability. Now comes the comparison of formative and summative. I know most of you will be knowing that, but you know, as a teacher, I always want to recall the previous prior knowledge so that you can make sense of what is the new knowledge that is coming up. So what would be the timing of formative assessment and summative assessment? Formative assessment could be any time that is before the final exam, before the summative exam. So it is throughout the learning process. But summative assessment, on the other hand, is an assessment that is meant for evaluation and should be at the end of an instructional unit or a course. Okay, let's look at the aims of formative and summative. So it's a long list, but I can highlight to make you understand what students are learning. So making your students' learning visible, to provide ongoing feedback, to improve teaching and learning, to help students identify their strengths, their weaknesses, their target areas of improvement. And then it should be used as an investigative tool for predictable patterns of connections and misconceptions, confusions, their knowledge, skills, and attitude gap. And then it should help faculty to recognize where the students are struggling so that they can address problems immediately. And it should aims to provide teachers with the necessary data to adjust the learning process while it is happening, not after the learning, during the learning. So what is summative then? To evaluate students' learning at the end of an instructional unit, to compare it against some standard or benchmark, to confirm what students know, to demonstrate whether or not they have met the curriculum outcomes, achieve the goals of their individualized program, to certify proficiency, to aim to reflect students' knowledge of a given area through a grade, to make decisions about students' future programs or placement. Okay, then what about the type? So there are so much into the formative assessment pool. Teacher and student interaction, question and answers, observations, performances, quizzes, concept maps, sentences identifying the main points during the lecture, e-portfolios, exit surveys. You name it and that is there. But make sure that that is for their learning. So these assessments are meant for learning, not of learning. Whereas in contrast, your summative assessment should be teacher controlled, like tests and exams, midterms, final projects, papers. And if you talk about the standardized exam, those are run externally. So what should be the consequences then? Your formative assessment should be low stake, focus on improvement, and your summative assessment should be of high stake, focusing on reporting and certification. So what about the quality? So your formative assessment should be high. The quality should be high. But summative, there is no chance to get it at the low quality. You must make it of high quality. Okay, some of the benefits of formative assessment. You can achieve your defined learning goals. You can increase the rigor. You can improve academic achievement. You can enhance student motivation. You can increase their engagement. You can scaffold them with focused and targeted feedback. You can achieve personalized learning experiences. And you can develop self-regulated learners. And what are the benefits of summative? You need to show a proof that the concept have been understood. You need to identify the weak areas. You need to determine the achievements, make academic records, boost individual confidence. You have to identify the weak areas of the student. And then you need to measure teacher and training success also. And then meant for evaluation, it is there to measure educator performance and then to gain a better understanding of the institution. Okay, this is in a nutshell. When you think about a curriculum, it cannot be a curriculum without assessment. So it's a part and parcel of the curriculum design. And the assessment is an interaction of three things. Aapko yaad rahegi figure. I'm a very visual teacher and I hope you all are very visual. So maybe you will retain all the information that is being displayed. So assessment is an interaction between the three things. One is the quality. The second is the format. And the third is the purpose. If you are clear as an educator that you are manipulating all these three in a very constructive manner, then you can say your assessment is serving the purpose. But how? आपके ज़हनों में ये सवाल आ रहा होगा कि but how? कहने को तो ये बहुत आसान है, लेकिन कैसे? आप लोगों ने एक टर्म सुनी होगी कंस्ट्रक्टिव अलाइनमेंट. ओके, लेट मी शो दैट. सो योर एंटायर असेसमेंट इज अ पार्ट ऑफ दैट. सो यू हैव टू इम्प्लीमेंट अ कंस्ट्रक्टिव अलाइनमेंट इन योर इंटेंडेड लर्निंग आउटकम्स, योर टीचिंग प्रैक्टिसेस एंड योर असेसमेंट. सो इंटेंडेड लर्निंग आउटकम मीन्स वॉट द स्टूडेंट हैज टू लर्न. सो वॉट आर द टारगेट गोल? What are you pointing towards? What is your main goal? And then your teaching comes in. It means that you are engaging your student in a way to achieve your intended learning outcomes. And the third one is assessment. You are assessing, either you are assessing the same intended learning outcome that you have used in your teaching practices or not. If you are not doing that, it means your assessment is misaligned. So you need to align all of these three. Okay, let me just help you to design a constructive aligned teaching and assessment. So first of all, you start with describing the intended learning outcomes in the form of standards students are to attain using appropriate learning verbs. So if you are using Bloom's taxonomy, it's very handy and you can have a verb list at each level. So you can just pick those verbs out of your Bloom's taxonomy and you can define, you can design, or you can describe intended learning outcomes. Then you create an environment likely to bring about that intended outcome. For example, you are at a create level, which is the top and the highest level of Bloom's taxonomy, and you want them to develop something new, to create something new and to be innovative. Then you have to provide the way or ways through which they can demonstrate that. And then use the assessment task enabling you to judge if they have achieved that or not. And after that, do we need to stop there? No. We have to use our grading criteria, or in some cases, the rubric for judging the quality of student performance. What is rubric and where we can use it? You can use a rubric in scoring essays, in scoring e-portfolios, performances of the students, behavioral observations. You can use it for student self-assessment. And for peer assessment as well. What are the two rubric types? Those are readily available. One is holistic and the other is analytic. Holistic is more like giving overall judgment of what your students are able to do, and an impression guided by quality descriptions. It's quick. It's just, you know, rating your students overall. But analytical means examining in detail each key aspect of the object and rated it separately. So assuming that each aspect could be independent of the other, but it is very time consuming. So where should we use it? What should be the purpose? Holistic rubric should be used where summative decision making is to be made. And there is little time to make a decision. It requires a little content expertise, so it can be used for self-assessment or peer assessment as well. Whereas in analytical rubric, you have to have formative decision making. You have enough time to make multiple judgments. You requires a lot of expertise to make multiple complex judgments. And probably it's not suitable for the student, but I used to use it for my students as well, because you need to first train them how to use it. If you have trained them how to use it, then you can use it for self and peer assessment as well. What is next? Aapke khayal mein kya hoga next slide mein? Then you have to prepare a report, which is a weak part in teaching. Which kind of report? Dekhen, the center part is the actual performance of your learner. And there is either two grids. Aap ye dekhenge ke the vertical one saying niche is easy and the upper one is hard. And the horizontal part is saying the answers which are wrong. And the left side is which they have got correct. So your report should be focusing on to these four areas and telling you about the strengths, the needs, the mastery level, and the gaps in your students' knowledge, skills, and attitude. Aap mein se kitne log hain jo ye karte hain? How many of you basically use it as a practice? Okay, so from now on, if you are not using it, you are not helping yourself to become a better instructor. So let me just help you a little further. Strengths mean, if you figure out that something is really hard and a student have got it corrected, it means that they have that strength in that particular area. So you can now advance into the more advanced content or the material with that student. If it is hard, but a student got it wrong, means you need to give them, you know, in a different way, the same concept, but use a different technique to make them learn. But if it is easy and everybody is getting is correct, then please stop teaching it. You don't need to teach it. And if it is easy and students are getting it wrong, it means that they need help. They need remedials. They need to practice at home. They need to practice individually. Okay, what is next? An activity is coming up. So what do you think? Before actually going to the emerging assessment trends, I really want you to think about the emerging teaching and learning models. So agar aap mere assist kar rahe hain mujhe ek student WhatsApp group mein, aur unhone shayad aapke saath ek activity share ki hogi, Abid Nazir, that is my e assistant. And Abid, can you please share that activity? Oh, already shared. Thank you, Abid. So this is the power of mobile learning. So you can have an e-assistant. G. So this is something. Answer Garden is a tool where you just give a question to the students and just ask them to brainstorm. So I would request Salim if they can show the cloud as well. Salim, would it be possible for you to do that for me? Suhail, can you please show us the answer garden? मैं जस्ट आपको दिखाना चाह रही हूँ और नेक्स्ट एक्टिविटी में यू कैन जस्ट गो एंड डू दैट. तो छोटी छोटी एक्टिविटीज यू कैन एड इन टू योर टीचिंग एंड लर्निंग टू मेक इट. मैंने आपसे पूछा है कि इमर्जिंग, अब ये देखें लोग रिस्पॉन्ड करना शुरू कर रहे हैं एंड देर इज अ क्लाउड दैट इज बिल्डिंग अप, द वर्ड क्लाउड. So you can help your students to just brainstorm. This is a brainstorm activity. और इसमें मल्टीपल एक्टिविटीज आई हैव इन्वॉल्व. तो हियर यू कैन सी, अब जैसे जैसे वो रिस्पॉन्ड करेंगे हर थोड़ी देर के बाद ये अपने आप को रिफ्रेश करेगा एंड न्यू एंट्रीज विल बी देयर. तो ये अभी अभी जो जो लोग हमारे पार्टिसिपेंट्स हैं, दे हैव पुट इन देयर, दे हैव पुट देयर यू नो इनपुट, दे हैव गिवन देयर इनपुट. सो इट्स ग्रोइंग एंड यू सी. और अगर आपको वर्ल्ड क्लाउड का थोड़ा सा कॉन्सेप्ट पता है तो ये है कि वट एवर इज बिकमिंग वेरी थिक, इट इज मीन्स दैट मोर पीपल आर एंटरिंग दैट ऑप्शन. तो जितना थिक होगा कोई वर्ड और जितना विजिबल होगा, इट मीन्स दैट पीपल आर गिविंग दैट ऑप्शन. सो इन अ लार्जर ऑडियंस वी यूजली यूज दैट. थैंक यू सुहेल, कैन यू प्लीज गो बैक टू माई स्लाइड. या सो अभी आपको दिखाते हैं और कौन कौन सी इमर्जिंग ट्रेंड्स हैं. लें जी, अब मैं आपको एक लॉन्ग लिस्ट दिखाने लगी हूँ, तो अपनी सीट बेल्ट बांध लें. लें जी, पहली स्लाइड, ये सारी नहीं है, इसके दो तीन स्लाइड्स में आपको डिवाइड कर. प्रॉब्लम बेस्ड लर्निंग अभी मैं इनके बारे में एक्सप्लेन नहीं कर सकती बिकॉज मेरा टारगेट अभी इस वक्त नहीं है, बट दी स्लाइड्स आर विद यू एंड यू कैन जस्ट गो एंड सर्च. देर इज टन्स ऑफ मटीरियल आउट देयर. So there are project-based or problem-based learning, discovery-based learning, inquiry-based learning, game-based learning, which is called gamification. It's becoming very popular. And it's, you know, it's popular among my students. Personalized and self-directed learning. Okay, next. Oh, by the way, all of these are learner-centered teaching and learning models. Blended learning. Aap mein se kuch logon ne blended learning likha, and that is there. Storytelling. Oh, this is becoming very popular. Just-in-time teaching. What is that? वैसे मेरा personal experience है, we are very expert in doing that. Just-in-time teaching. No preparation. Go in the class. Thak. Concepts. लेकिन just-in-time teaching यहाँ पे that is not the same. That is like a question is coming to you and you mold the way you teach based on the question that has been asked. That is called just-in-time teaching. So sometimes ये होता है, मैं एक ही class, एक ही content, multiple classes को पढ़ाती हूँ और students ये कहते हैं कि आपने बिल्कुल different पढ़ाया है एक section को और बिल्कुल different पढ़ाया दूसरे section को. How come it is possible? तो मैं कहती हूँ it all depends on you. How connected I feel. How responsive you are. What kind of questions you are putting forward. That make my teaching different. So it is, I'm a very good at just-in-time teaching because I know lots and lots of stories. I know lots and lots of experiences. मैं मलेशिया रही और उसमें students को बात समझाने के लिए I have to quote कि मलेशिया में ऐसे होता था, मलेशिया में इस तरह से. मेरे students अक्सर जो दो तीन classes ले चुके हैं वो तो तंग पड़ जाते हैं कि मैडम मलेशिया का बड़ा जिक्र करती हैं. लेकिन I used to tell the stories because that made me, you know, realize that I have learned a lot while my stay outside the country. And that's why I, you know, inspire my student to go outside the country for the study. Then there is makeification. How many of you know about maker education? If you don't know, please go and find it out. Makeification is becoming very popular. And then mobile learning. See, I have mobile in my hand and I am using it during my teaching. I use a lot. This little computing device, that is the power of a teacher. You should learn it to use it. And then there are more adaptive learning, which we are going to discuss in the last session of today. And Dr. Sajid is here to, you know, tell us all about. So adaptive learning ke saath adaptive assessment bhi sikhayenge hume. And then differentiated learning, where you need to understand the differences among your students. And then you have to have strategies to deal with those differentiated learners. And then augmented and virtual reality based learning, blended MOOCs. How many of you know about the MOOC? What is MOOC? Massive open online courses. जब से मुझे ये पता चला ना, मैसिव ओपन ऑनलाइन कोर्सेज, दैट चेंज्ड द वे आई यूज टू लर्न न्यू थिंग्स. आई यूज टू गो टू कोर्सेरा, एडएक्स, यूडेसिटी, एंड देयर आर सो मेनी प्लेटफॉर्म्स आउट देयर. स्टैनफोर्ड, एमआईटी, हर तरह के टीचर से मैं पढ़ चुकी हूँ. कैसे? घर बैठे. how to move. So please learn that. And then the artificial intelligence based learning, kyunki aapka second session hai mere saath, that is all about that. Okay, now the second activity is think about the emerging assessment trends. Emerging teaching and learning models aapke samne maine rakh diye. Ab aap ye sochein ki emerging e-assessment trend kya honge. So please do this activity, emerging assessment trends in e-learning. We were just having a brainstorm session regarding emerging assessment trends. So let me just share some of them with you, and I'll be focusing, I'll be sharing my own personal experience of using some of them, and I'll leave you with some of them that you need to explore once you go back. So these are some emerging assessment trends: game-based assessment, e-portfolios, online response systems, differentiated assessment, adaptive assessment, self-paced and personalized assessment, using web 2.0 tools for assessment, concept mapping, one of my favorite. You will see many concept maps, those are coming up. And then AI based, jo ki mera next session is totally on AI in education. And then blockchain, that is coming up, that is the future of education and the assessment based on blockchain. Okay, starting with game based assessment, you also call it gamified assessment or gamification. Advantages ye hai ji ki you have to create a competitive environment where your students are following certain rules so that they can achieve certain goals, just like the games which your kids used to play. What happens while you do this, use it in your classrooms, your students feel engaged, and you try to have enough evidence to match with the outcomes. There are a variety of settings you can use, and most importantly, you gain attention of your students. I have used it several times in my classes, and I have seen that how ek jo kehte na bachon wala element in all of our students, they really want to compete with each other. They really want to achieve something in with respect to their fellows. What are the limitations? The limitations are the competition concerns. So sometimes it becomes a little negative. So this is the responsibility of teacher to keep the positive and healthy competition. And then sometimes the level of difficulty becomes high if you are not considerate of their cognitive load. And then expensive in terms of time. Bazooka to ye hota hai ki mujhe students ko ye kehna padta hai ki please, time over ho gaya, let me just go. If they said no, we have to complete it, we have to do to the next level. And then sometimes misdirection of intention bhi ho jati hai, because students are engaged so much and they get addicted of that game. So uske liye platforms, to ye aap jaldi se iski tasveer khench le, aap slides milengi. To ye Kahoot is one of my favorite game based platform for gamified assessment. Quizlet, Formative, Scratch, R of Code, Alice, Quiz eToys, and robotic. अच्छा, अब मैं क्योंकि टीचर्स ट्रेनिंग भी करती हूँ, तो टीचर्स को जो असाइनमेंट मिलती है ना, उनके अंदर मैं उनसे कहती हूँ कि मुझे ना इनके कंपेरिजन दें, तो वो भी आगे आपको दिखाऊंगी एक स्टूडेंट का रिस्पॉन्स. तो जब आपने ये प्लेटफॉर्म्स सीख लिए, इट्स वेरी ईजी फॉर यू टू जस्ट यूज इट इन योर क्लासरूम. फिर है जी सेकेंड, ई पोर्टफोलियोज, एन अदर फेवरेट ऑफ माइन. इसमें क्या करते हैं, जैसे पोर्टफोलियो is meant for collection of evidences of your work, of your designs, of your skills, is showcasing what you have known and what you have learned, what you are good at. You just convert that into electronic format. And iske liye jo platforms hum use karenge, usme aapke samne ek list hai. My favorite one is Google Sites, which is free. अगर आपका आपके इंस्टीट्यूट जो है वो फ्री वर्जन, जो एक एकेडमिक वर्जन के ऊपर काम कर रहे हैं, तो यू विल गॉट अनलिमिटेड स्पेस एंड योर गूगल साइट इज वन ऑफ द वे यू कैन क्रिएट. अच्छा, आई वुड रिक्वेस्ट आबिद, हु इज वर्किंग एज अ वर्चुअल असिस्टेंट ऑफ माइंड, टू प्लीज शेयर टू सैंपल्स ऑफ ई पोर्टफोलियोज विद द ऑडियंस इन द चैट बॉक्स एज वेल एज in the WhatsApp group. जब आप ये देखेंगे तो आपको उसमें नजर आएगा कि विच आई यूज टू यूज इन माई क्लास के एट द एज एन एंड प्रोजेक्ट आई यूज टू आस्क देम टू मेक एन ई पोर्टफोलियो एंड आई यूज टू आस्क देम टू पुट ऑल देयर असाइनमेंट्स विच दे हैव डन थ्रू आउट प्लस सम कंपोनेंट न्यू अ न्यू कंपोनेंट. फॉर एग्जाम्पल मैं आपको मिसाल देती हूँ कि जैसे आई हैव बीन डूइंग आई हैव बीन टीचिंग माई स्टूडेंट्स द सब्जेक्ट इंस्ट्रक्शनल टेक्नोलॉजीज. तो उसमें उनको ये था कि दे हैव टू पिक वन टूल आउट ऑफ अ पूल ऑफ मनी एंड दे हैव टू लर्न दैट टूल बाय देमसेल्व्स एंड देन हैव टू क्रिएट सम आर्टिफैक्ट. फॉर एग्जांपल स्क्रीन कास्टिंग करनी है, ट्यूटोरियल्स बनाने हैं, उसके कॉन्सेप्ट मैप्स बनाने हैं, उसका पोस्टर बनाना है, उसके एक और चीज मैं कराती हूँ, पावर पॉइंट स्लाइड्स बनानी है एंड दे पुट दैट एज योर आर्टिफैक्ट एज योर एज द एविडेंस ऑफ योर वर्क इन योर प्री पोर्टफोलियो along with your CV, your teaching philosophy, your reflection part and all that. And they have come up with so much new ideas. You can use it for any subject. So why e-portfolio assessment is very important and effective? Because it is assessing overall performance of your student. It is assessing tangible and ongoing products. And it also requires students to self-reflect. In every e-portfolio, I have a component that is called the reflection part. Ek page hamesha uska hota reflection ka. What have you learned throughout the process? What were the aha moments? What were the stuck moments? How did you get out of the stuck situation? What did you feel now? Aur aap yakeen karein ke once they have made something new, they are so much excited and motivated to even mazukat to mujhe students kehte hain ki madam ye e-portfolio ka project jo hai na ये जिसको आ जाए ना उसका दिल नहीं करता इसको छोड़ने को. बिकॉज एवरी टाइम यू गो एंड विजिट योर ई पोर्टफोलियो यू नीड टू इम्प्रूव इट, यू टेंड टू इम्प्रूव इट. तो आप देख लें ऑथेंटिक असेसमेंट के साथ कैसे रिलेट करता है और ट्रेडिशनल असेसमेंट. तो ट्रेडिशनल असेसमेंट इज फोकसिंग ऑन टू वेरी नैरो एरियाज वेयर एज ई पोर्टफोलियो इज असेसिंग द ओवरऑल परफॉर्मेंस ऑफ अ स्टूडेंट. देन कम्स द डिफरेंशिएटेड लर्निंग एंड असेसमेंट. मेरा आपसे सवाल, हाउ हैव यू used assessment to determine the differences in your students' learning need? How did this influence the instruction that followed? Kaise pata chalega? Koi diagnostic test, koi aisi question answer jisse pata chale ki aapke paas jo students baithe hain, how different they are? What are the different needs of those students? Kaise pata chalega? Aap mein se kabhi kisi ne class ke start mein hi janne ki koshish ki ho के what kind of students I am going to teach in this session, what are their strengths and what are the weaknesses. अगर नहीं किया तो आज के बाद आप जानने की कोशिश करें. क्यों? क्योंकि आप ये ना कर रहे हो जो इस कार्टून के अंदर, कॉमिक के अंदर है. You will be giving same exam but people having different ability. What you have to do, consider individual need and capabilities. How? This is a concept map I've created after reading differentiation. Kyunki ye aa raha tha koi 4-5 slides pe, maine kaha mere paas to 4-5 slides ki gunjaish nahi hai, so I just made this concept map. You can also made that. It's very easy to make. Sab pehli dafa dekhta hai na, wo kehta hai ji ye kaise banega. To jab wo tool seekh leta to wo fir kehta hai bas sab mujhe yahi banane ko de. Okay, starting with differentiation is a teacher's proactive response that is guy. Ab padhte jaye, you just follow the arrow and you just start reading it from the start till the end. So the superordinate concept is at the top. Superordinate concept is the most generalized concept jis jo ke focus kar raha hai is pure concept map, that is at the top. Or agar sometimes you just put it in the center as well. So differentiation is a teacher's proactive response guided by general principles. Those are your environment should encourage and support learning, your assessment that should inform the teaching and learning, your instruction that respond to the student variance, your you need to lead students and manage their routine, and then you have to have a quality in your curriculum. Plus you also, your proactive response should be shaped by your mindset and should be according to the learner's need. Plus that can be done through different ways. चार वेज बताए हुए आपको, कंटेंट के जरिए, प्रोसेस के जरिए, प्रोडक्ट एंड देन इफेक्ट और एनवायरनमेंट. सो व्हेन यू मैनिपुलेट दीज फोर यू कैन affect the readiness of the student. You can affect the interest, or you can influence the interest of the student. Plus, you can also develop their learning profile. What kind of a learner do you want them to become? Self-directed or not? हमारे यहाँ जो teaching का style है, that leads to a dependent student. So never do that, because this is not the time of dependent learners. This is the time of self-directed learners. How you would achieve that? First of all, you need to develop that in your own self. So ये थे जी key elements of effective differentiation instruction. So what this concept map is doing, it's condensing the information into a concept that is easily understood by the audience. इसपे सबसे ज्यादा मेहनत उस वक्त होती है जब आप बना रहे होते हैं, आपकी अंडरस्टैंडिंग उसी वक्त क्लैरिफाई होती है. और आई हैव ऑलवेज ट्राइड टू रिविजिट एंड यू नो मेक सम एडजस्टमेंट्स आफ्टरवर्ड्स. तो डिफरेंशिएटेड टेक्निक्स के अंदर ये कुछ टेक्निक्स हैं आपके सामने, जिसमें लर्निंग एंड इंटरेस्ट सेंटर्स, आपके मेन्यूज डिफरेंट, जैसे आप खाने के लिए डिफरेंट मेन्यूज होते हैं ना, तो उसमें डिफरेंट चीजें होती हैं. तो आपके स्टूडेंट्स की जो असेसमेंट है उसमें भी डिफरेंट ऑप्शंस, द वे दे यूज टू गो फॉर दैट. जैसे मैंने आपको बताया कि मैं उनको कहती हूँ कि एक टूल सिलेक्ट करें आउट ऑफ अ विकी दैट इज बेस्ड ऑन एजुकेशनल टूल्स, और उसके अंदर देयर इज अ वैरायटी ऑफ 200 प्लस टूल्स आर देयर, एंड दे आर फ्री टू चूज एनी टूल, यू नो प्रोवाइडेड दे आर देयर टू एक्सप्लेन दैट. And then you need to scaffold reading and writing, intelligence preferences, tiered assessment. Yani aap ek first level, second level, third level of assessment. Do not just give assessment that is not related to each other. Sometimes you need to give an assessment that is related to the previous assessment. Then you have to have learning contracts, RAF take method hai, TikTok complex instruction, jiske andar aap ek TikTok bana dete hain. For example, 3x3 ka grid bana diya, uske andar aapne 9 क्वेश्चन लिख दिए. 3x3 मीन्स 9 क्वेश्चन लिख दिए. अब हर स्टूडेंट को आपने कहा कि यू नीड टू आंसर वन क्वेश्चन, और जिसने एक रो में 3 क्वेश्चन कर दिए वो दैट स्टूडेंट विल विन द गेम. इंडिपेंडेंट प्रोजेक्ट्स, एक्सप्रेशन ऑप्शंस, एंड देन स्मॉल ग्रुप इंस्ट्रक्शंस. उसके बाद सेल्फ पेस्ड, पर्सनलाइज्ड, ऑनलाइन रिस्पॉन्स, ये सब कुछ हम डिफरेंट टूल्स अवेलेबल हैं मार्केट में. तो आई जस्ट गिव यू अ फ्लेवर ऑफ देम. जैसे फॉर्मेटिव असेसमेंट टूल में गूगल फॉर्म, प्लिकर, पूल एवरीवेयर, मेंटीमीटर, नियर पॉड, और आप आज भी जो यूज किया आपने आंसर गार्डन, नजर आ रहा है आपको. इनके मैंने लिंक्स प्रोवाइड कर दिए हैं आपको स्लाइड्स पे, सो दैट यू कैन गो एंड एक्सप्लोर. तो हर अच्छा अभी एक मैंने असाइनमेंट भी दी थी जो आपको रिस्पॉन्स अभी दिखाने लगी हूँ. आई हैव आस्क्ड वन ऑफ माई एमफिल क्लास टू कंपेयर ऑल दीज टूल्स. इसमें से कोई मेरा ख्याल है सारे तो नहीं, शायद मेरा ख्याल है 10 के करीब टूल्स उनको देके कंपेयर देम ऑन अ सर्टेन क्राइटेरिया. ये देखें जी, ये एक स्टूडेंट है हमारी पूरा तुलैन सर्वत, उनका ये रिस्पांस था. अब दिस इज वन पेज सबमिशन, बट कैन यू इमेजिन द वर्किंग बिहाइंड दिस सबमिशन. कितना टाइम लगा होगा उसको ये असाइनमेंट करने में. एंड सी there are सबसे आप देखें ऊपर horizontally, sorry vertically there are names of the tools, and vertically there are their features. कि कौन कौन सी assessment type हो सकती हैं, MCQ है, true false, short questions, open ended questions, interactivity का level क्या है, question library है नहीं है, web based assignments की facility है कि नहीं, gamification included है कि नहीं, and then does it save your time, reporting and statistics है कि नहीं. और आप ये देखेंगे कि ये स्टूडेंट का रिस्पांस था आफ्टर गोइंग थ्रू ईच एंड एवरी टूल, दे हैव कम अप विद दिस एनालिटिकल चार्ट जिसके अंदर उन्होंने सारे फीचर्स को एनालाइज किया. अच्छा जी, अब वेब 2.0 इज बिकमिंग वेरी पॉपुलर, सो यू नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट व्हाई इट इज इम्पॉर्टेंट. सो नाउ दैट फॉर्म ऑफ असेसमेंट इज नॉट लाइक अ स्टूडेंट टीचर रिलेशनशिप. नो, स्टूडेंट कर रहा है और टीचर उसको असेस कर रहा है. नो, इट्स लाइक अ कलेक्टिव एफर्ट. लाइक मैं ये देखना चाहती हूँ कि मेरे बाकी स्टूडेंट्स भी एक दूसरे का काम देखें. तो देयर कम्स द वेब 2.0, इसके अंदर आप उनको फॉर एग्जांपल ब्लॉग्स के जरिए, विकीज, वन ऑफ माय फेवरेट टूल विकीज, में यू शेयर द इंफॉर्मेशन, यू आस्क द स्टूडेंट्स टू शेयर इट कोलैबोरेटिव. बाय द वे, वेब 2.0 के बारे में मुझे नहीं पता आप लोगों को पता है कि नहीं, दिस इज डिफरेंट देन द वेब 1.0 थी रीड ओनली वेब, एंड वेब 2.0 है जी रीड राइट शेयर एंड कोलैबोरेट. रीड राइट शेयर एंड कोलैबोरेट. सो हियर वी यूज टू गिव असाइनमेंट्स और असेसमेंट इन अ वे दैट स्टूडेंट्स हैज टू जी. वेब 3.0 भी है विच इज ऑल्सो नाउ कमिंग अप और हम यूज कर रहे हैं, मजे की बात है. एंड दैट इज कॉल्ड इंटेलिजेंट वेब विच कैन मेक डिसीजंस फॉर यू. एंड देन प्रोडक्टिविटी एप्स हैं जिसमें आप स्टूडेंट्स को कहते हैं कि जी कोई चीज बना के दिखाएं. अभी मैं आपको मिसाल भी दिखाऊंगी. सोशल बुक मार्किंग, मीडिया, मल्टी मीडिया शेयरिंग, सोशल नेटवर्क, मैशअप, पॉडकास्टिंग, फोटो शेयरिंग, वीडियो शेयरिंग. और आप उनको कहें कि वीडियो बना के दिखाएं, कोई एक्टिविटी करें और उसकी वीडियो बना के दिखाएं, दे वुड लव इट. एंड सम ऑफ माय स्टूडेंट्स दे हैव स्टार्टेड देयर ओन वीडियो चैनल्स ऑन यूट्यूब बिकॉज ऑफ दोज असाइनमेंट्स. अब इसका फायदा क्या है? इसका फायदा है पोर्टेबिलिटी, ईज टू प्रोड्यूस, यू हैव सम ऑथेंटिक ऑडियंस, कनेक्टेडनेस विच इज मच मच नीडेड, एंड सोशल अवेयरनेस, एंड समटाइम्स ऑब्वियसली यू गेट अ बेनिफिट बींग फ्री. तो लिमिटेशंस क्या है? एक्सेस टू नेसेसरी सोफिस्टिकेटेड हार्डवेयर, इनस्टेबिलिटी ऑफ ओपन सोर्स एप्स, क्वालिटी ऑफ द मैसेज विच यू पास थ्रू दोज एप्लीकेशन, हाउ क्रेडिबल दोज टूल्स आर, हाउ टू डील विद द बायसेस यू हैव क्रिएटेड. देयर आर सम सेफ्टी इश्यूज एज वेल, एंड पॉसिबिलिटी ऑफ साइबर बुलिंग इज ऑलवेज देयर. ओके, द कॉन्सेप्ट मैपिंग. व्हाई वी यूज कॉन्सेप्ट मैप? बिकॉज आई डोंट लाइक टू गिव देम एसे क्वेश्चंस. And essay questions is there to make them understand the content deeply. So what I used to tell them, make a concept map out of it. Okay. So this is a concept map of a concept map. What it is? It said, अगर आप ये ऊपर से बार को please हटा दीजिए, तो इसको नीचे ले जाएं. ये देखिए. So we start with the superordinate concept, that is a concept map that represent an organized knowledge, and that is based. You start a concept map with the help of a focus question. And organized knowledge is, सबसे पहले एक चीज, concept होता क्या है? What is a concept? अब अपने students से पूछती हूँ ना, तो वो कहेंगे understanding, knowledge. भाई मैं पूछ रही हूँ concept की जो एक research based definition है. So concept is about, you know, is consist of two things. One is called label, and the other is called perceived regularities. जो भी परसीव्ड रेगुलरिटीज हैं वो उस कॉन्सेप्ट का हिस्सा है. जैसे ये चेयर है, तो चेयर का लेबल क्या है? चेयर. और इसकी परसीव्ड रेगुलरिटी क्या है? कि ये फिक्स्ड है. अगर ये मैं सेंटर वाली चेयर को देख रही हूँ, तो ये येलो कलर की है, ये इसका फैब्रिक है, दो साइड पे आर्मरेस्ट है, एक बैक है, इट इज स्टिफ. ये सारी जो मैं बोल रही हूँ, दीज आर द रेगुलरिटीज, परसीव्ड रेगुलरिटीज. तो ऑर्गेनाइज नॉलेज दैट शुड बी कॉन्टेक्स्ट डिपेंडेंट. And that context could be social and personal. It should necessarily be using for effective teaching and effective learning. And how do you make a concept map? By connecting two concepts with the help of a preposition. So it makes sense or flow. Yani aap start kare from very start till the end. So it should make a link. So ye aap dekh lenge inshallah. Time nahi hai abhi, main isko pure ko go through karun. But it's very handy and very effective. How can you make it? I have given you a label there, TMAP tools. It is free, and just by, you know, using a few tries, you can just make a very good concept map. Self and peer assessment. Dekhen ji, teen tarah ki aap assessment lete hain. Ek to teacher assessment, ek peer assessment, ek self assessment. Iske bare mein you need to be very careful, because your peer assessment and self assessment is. Peer assessment is more like appraisal of my work by a fellow learner. Yani mera apna colleague, jo class fellow hai, wo usko assess karega in relation to a specific learning intention, goal, or a set of criteria. So I need to develop that set of criteria beforehand. And self-assessment is appraisal of my own work in relation to a specific learning intention, goal, or a set of criteria. Ye dekhen, ye ek mere student ne banaya, Abid Nazir ne. ये मैंने उसको दिया जस्ट फॉर फॉर द सेक ऑफ यू नो मेकिंग कॉपिंग. किसी बुक से उसने बल्कि रेफरेंस नीचे दिया होगा, यहाँ से उसने ये डायग्राम बनाई और मैंने इसमें कुछ चेंजेस करने से. तो आई डिड नॉट यूज द सेम बुक इमेज. आई आस्क्ड हिम टू रीड्रॉ इट एंड देन आई हैव टू चेंज सम एरोस. तो आप ये देखें, ये पीयर और सेल्फ असेसमेंट को शो कर रहा है कि वेन एवर आई मेक सर्टन, अगर आप लेफ्ट साइड को देखें विच इज सेल्फ असेसमेंट लूप, यू रिकॉर्ड अ प्रेजेंटेशन, यू आस्क योर स्टूडेंट्स टू रिफ्लेक्ट ऑन दैट, एंड इफ द स्टूडेंट्स आर सेटिस्फाइड विद योर प्रेजेंटेशन दे विल गो टू द पीयर असेसमेंट. ठीक है. And once they finish their self-assessment loop, they'll have to enter into the peer assessment loop. In there, they have to assess their fellows' assessment, and they have to reflect on that. And that reflection has that assessment and reflection has been shared with the class. So a student that has been peer assessed by a fellow class fellow, they have to have. Sometimes students मेरे पास आते हैं कि जी ये मेरी assessment ठीक नहीं हुई, तो I used to tell them to go back and you know ask them again to reassess according to the rubric that is provided. So this is the loop and through which you help your students to first assess themselves and then assess their peers. The second part is all about artificial intelligence. This is one of the emerging area which I really want my fellow colleagues to know about, and this is emerging, and from a job perspective, agar main dekhun ki in coming days there will be thousands and thousands of jobs in that, they'll be needing teachers to teach in AI. So I'll be just giving you a little flavor and then you can just explore that domain. So ji, hum discuss karenge what is AI, how does it work, who is using it, how AI interact with education, and what happens after that interaction, what are the risks and challenges, what are the implications of AI in education, and what are the future directions of AI in education. So agar ye abhi hum nahi dekh rahe, ye jo answer garden hai, you people can go back and just watch how this answer garden is growing as the responses. Lekin most of the time हमारे जहनों में जो इमेज आता है वो ऑटोमेटेड मशीन्स, ऑटोनोमस कार्स, ड्राइवरलेस कार्स जो हैं, और रोबोट्स, जैसे कि और भी लोगों ने कहा. तो ये वो सारी चीज़ें जो आपके जहन में आती हैं, लेकिन एजुकेशन से रिलेटेड क्या जहन में आता है, बहुत कम चीज़ें. तो सबसे पहले आपने ये देखना है कि AI है क्या. तो AI ये है जी, ऑफन यूज टू डिस्क्राइब मशीन्स और कंप्यूटर सिस्टम दैट मिमिक cognitive functions that a human associate humans associate with the human mind. Yani aapko lagega ki humans kar sakte hain, lekin machines are also doing that, such as learning, problem solving and decision making. So this is the definition of AI. So where AI in terms of domain, to aap ye dekhenge sabse jo aapko red color ka circle nazar aa raha hai sabse upar, wo computer science hai, aur uska ek subset hai artificial intelligence. और artificial intelligence के अंदर again there are two subfields, those are called machine learning and deep learning. कैसे काम करता है AI? Example आपके सामने है कि आप एक classifier है आपकी email का, which is using AI ML model, and उसका काम ये है कि जो भी आपकी email आती है उसको दो categories में divide कर देता है खुद ब खुद based on the content of that email. एक है जी आपका inbox और दूसरा आपका स्पैम फोल्डर. तो ये जो स्पैम फोल्डर में खुद ब खुद आपकी ईमेल्स चली जाती हैं, दैट इज बिकॉज ऑफ द कंटेंट दैट इज बीइंग मॉनिटर्ड बाय योर मशीन एंड द सॉफ्टवेयर. तो ये अगर आप गूगल जीमेल आपने यूज की हो, तो दे हैव एन AI मैकेनिज्म दैट इज बिहाइंड दैट. तो दिस इज वन ऑफ वेरी सिंपल एग्जाम्पल हाउ AI वुड वर्क. अब एक और क्वेश्चन, ये जो एक्टिविटीज आगे आ रही है ये आपने घर जाके करनी है. ये एक्टिविटीज हैं एक क्विक ड्रॉ है जिसमें एक मशीन आपके सामने होगी, आप उसके सामने ड्रॉ करेंगे और वो गेस करेगी कि व्हाट हैव यू ड्रॉन. तो दिस इज द AI बेस्ड मशीन. जितना अच्छा आप ड्रॉ करेंगे उतना अच्छा वो गेस करेगी, लेकिन समटाइम्स यू ड्रॉ वेरी पैथेटिकली एज ह्यूमन ड्रॉज एंड मशीन यूज टू गेस दैट. तो ये आप जाके खुद करेंगे, ये डूडलिंग डेटा यहाँ पे है वो आप देख लेंगे. एक और AI की एक्टिविटी है जिसमें आप कोई भी तस्वीर दे दें मशीन को और वो मशीन उसकी कैप्शन ढूंढ के ले आती है. जैसे एक आपने बेबी की फोटो दी है जिसने पिंक कलर का ड्रेस पहना है, तो मशीन वुड टेल यू दैट कि अ बेबी इन अ पिंक ड्रेस. तो ये दो एक्टिविटीज मैं स्टूडेंट्स को दिखाने के लिए करती हूँ, तो ये आप घर जाके कर लीजिएगा. कहाँ कहाँ यूज हो रहा है यार, bankers have been using it, doctors have been using it, professionals have been using it, researchers have been using it, students have been using it, and instructors should use it. सारी दुनिया यूज करके जब तंग आ जाती है फिर इंस्ट्रक्टर्स उसको यूज करते हैं. तो एजुकेशन इज द डोमेन वेयर वी आर इंटरेस्टेड टू डिग फर्दर इन एंड वी वांट टू सी हाउ एआई इज गोइंग टू इंटरैक्ट विद एजुकेशन. एआई इज एवरीवेयर एंड दिस इज द फ्यूचर ऑफ एआई. अगर आप ये ना कि अब जो डेटा साइंस और अब जो बच्चे आपके हायर एजुकेशन में हैं उनके लिए द स्कोप इज इन एआई. अच्छा जी, होता क्या है? Once AI is interacting with education, there are three main categories. Those are emerged: learning with AI, learning about AI, and preparing yourself for AI. Because AI is going to happen in our daily life. It is something which is now becoming part of your personal devices. So the third part is to dealing with that. So you need to prepare yourself to use it. So I am really concerned about the first category, which is learning with AI. So I'll just tell you about more. So ye teen buckets hain aur usme se main aaj pehli bucket ko aapko khol ke dikhana chahti hu. To pehli bucket hai ji student facing AI, yani student aise tools aur aisi machines ke sath interact kar rahe hain jo unki learning ko affect karegi. And then teacher facing AI, teachers aise tools and techniques and machines use kar rahe hain jo ki AI based hain. And then system facing AI, यानी obviously educational एक system है, उसका अपना एक mechanism है, उसके अंदर finance, administration, overall management सब कुछ आ जाता है. तो how AI is helping that? And a fourth जो है वो आपके लिए छोड़ रही हूँ, घर जाके इसको इस पर गौर कीजिएगा, learning about learning through AI. Okay, तो so first of all system facing AI, ये क्या है? इसमें कोई भी इंस्टीट्यूशन है, दे कैन ऑटोमेट देयर एडमिशन प्रोसेसेस, देयर टाइम टेबलिंग, देयर लर्निंग मैनेजमेंट, अटेंडेंस रिकॉर्डिंग, एंड दे कैन ऑल्सो प्रिडिक्ट विच स्टूडेंट्स आर एट रिस्क ऑफ फेलियर. दिस इज सिस्टम फेसिंग एआई, बट वी आर नॉट कंसर्न विद दैट राइट नाउ. वी आर कंसर्न विद स्टूडेंट फेसिंग एआई. तो सबसे पहले इंटेलिजेंट ट्यूटरिंग सिस्टम्स, दोज आर कमिंग अप. और ये मैंने लंबी लिस्ट आपको दे दी है, प्लीज डू विजिट सम ऑफ देम टू अंडरस्टैंड हाउ डज इट वर्क. जैसे मैंने एलेक्स पे काम किया हुआ है. एलेक्स इज वन ऑफ द मैथमेटिकल प्लेटफॉर्म जिसमें ये होता है कि यू स्टार्ट विद सम डायग्नोस्टिक टेस्ट एंड दे प्लेस यू इन नॉलेज स्पेस कि आपके ये कॉन्सेप्ट ठीक हैं और अब आप ये फर्दर कॉन्सेप्ट पढ़ सकते हैं, ठीक है. एंड होल सिस्टम इज ऑटोमेटेड, यू डोंट नीड एनी इंस्ट्रक्टर, यू जस्ट इंटरेक्ट विद द मशीन एंड you know slowly and gradually machines help you to you know increase your knowledge in terms of you know the lower concepts. First you complete the lower concepts and then higher and then higher. So these are some of the intelligent tutoring systems in front of you. Then comes dialogue based tutoring system in which the machine is talking to the student, helping them to make their learning happen, showcasing them what they can do and how they can do, and you know it's a dialogue based. So there is a whole database that is jab student ne ko baat ki to usko kaise respond back kiya. To isko aap agar aapne kabhi Google ki unse Siri se baat ki ho, so that is one of the example of the dialogue based system. So why don't we just bring it into the learning? So there are certain, just a tutor, auto tutor, sur system, caller, Watson tutor. ये वो सारे dialogue based tutoring system है, in which your instant natural जो language understanding है that has been done by the computers and they respond you accordingly. और student को sometimes ये feel भी नहीं होता कि it's a machine. A student usually thinks that it is someone that is at the end answering there. Queries or questions. Then comes exploratory learning environments. और उसके लिए भी मैंने आपको कुछ examples दी हैं, Betty's Brain, Crystal Island, Echoes and Fractions Lab. इसमें यह है कि कुछ ऐसी activities जिसमें उनको explore करना है. जैसे for example, हो सकता है future में कोई physics से related ऐसी game बन जाए या AI based एक कोई platform develop करें जिसमें वो डिफरेंट जगहों पे जा रहे हैं और वो चीजें एक्सप्लोर कर रहे हैं. जैसे फॉर एग्जांपल एक कॉन्सेप्ट किस किस कॉन्सेप्ट की फाउंडेशन में आता है वो उसको देख रहे हैं. एंड देन कम्स द ऑटोमेटिक राइटिंग इवेल्युएशन. ये तो सब टीचर्स को बड़ी ख्वाहिश है इसकी, और फ्यूचर में यू नीड टू बी हैविंग दैट वेयर ई रेटर्स, इंटेलिजेंट एसी असेसर्स, एंड यू नीड समवन टू हेल्प यू टू असेस योर स्टूडेंट्स राइटिंग बिकॉज इट इज वेरी टाइम कंज्यूमिंग. देन कम्स ऑटोमेटिक एसे राइटिंग. अब ये मैं अगर अपने स्टूडेंट्स को बता दूं, अब पता नहीं मेरे स्टूडेंट्स ऑनलाइन होंगे कि देयर कम्स द ऑटोमेटिक एसे राइटिंग एज वेल. तो AI राइटर्स, और जिसके अंदर ये मैंने आपको टूल्स कुछ बताए हैं, तो यू कैन ट्राई दैट. लर्निंग नेटवर्क ऑर्केस्ट्रेटर्स. ऑर्केस्ट्रेटर्स के अंदर आप इंडिविजुअली स्टूडेंट, यानी ये दैट इज मेंट फॉर इंडिविजुअलाइज्ड एंड सेल्फ बेस्ड लर्निंग. इसमें एक स्टूडेंट और एक इंस्ट्रक्टर, यानी वन टू वन कम्युनिकेशन हो रही है. और कैसे हो रही है? थ्रू AI मशीन. यानी हर स्टूडेंट ये समझ रहा है कि उसको जो टीचर पढ़ा रहा है वो सिर्फ उसको पढ़ा रहा है, एंड दैट इज ओनली पॉसिबल बाय यूजिंग द AI सपोर्ट. लर्निंग लैंग्वेजेस. डुओलिंगो का नाम आपने सुना होगा बहुत ज्यादा. तो देर आर अदर प्लेटफॉर्म्स ऑल्सो, दोज आर हेल्पिंग स्टूडेंट्स टू लर्न डिफरेंट लैंग्वेजेस. देर इज अ मिक्स्ड रियलिटी टीचर ऑर्केस्ट्रेशन. इसमें ये है कि आप देख रहे हैं आप ये स्क्रीन पे, देर आर स्टूडेंट्स हैविंग द AI सिस्टम्स इन देयर मशीन्स एंड दे आर वर्चुअल रियलिटी बेस्ड. आप देख रहे हैं साथ आपको कुछ इमेजेस नजर आ रहे हैं हर टर्मिनल के साथ. तो स्टूडेंट्स मस्ट बी वेयरिंग सम काइंड ऑफ स्पेशल ग्लासेस एंड ऑल दैट, एंड दे विल बी हैविंग दैट फीलिंग ऑफ मिक्स्ड रियलिटी, वर्चुअल रियलिटी अलॉन्ग विद टीचर ऑर्केस्ट्रेशंस. एंड इन फ्रंट यू कैन सी देयर इज एन एनालिटिकल व्यू which student is at which level during the class. So this can also happen through AI. Then there are chatbots. Chatbots are the ones who are there to, you know, aapne aapko kabhi experience hua hai ki aap kisi website pe gaye, aapne abhi question type kiya aur saath hi thak karke answer aa gaya. So those are the chatbots. Yani those are not humans who are answering you. Those are the machines who are answering you based on the questions you have posed. And then there is smart curation of the learning material, much needed for the instructors. Okay, how to curate learning material according to the subject, according to the learning objectives. So ye ek platform main aapke samne leke aayi hu. Then there is a learning with jahan pe teacher facing aa gaya. Ye ek bada hi zabardast tool hai, teacher advisor with Watson. ये करता क्या है, ये आपके कंटेंट को पहले डाइजेस्ट करता है, फिर उसमें से आइडेंटिफाई करता है टारगेटेड कॉन्सेप्ट एंड कीवर्ड्स, और फिर आपको सरफेस कर देता है बेस्ट मैच ऑफ योर क्वेरी. तो ये इसके अंदर जो डेटाबेस है वो सारा टीचिंग एंड लर्निंग से रिलेटेड है. इट इज मेंट फॉर हेल्पिंग अ टीचर अकॉर्डिंग टू व्हाट ही नीड्स फॉर द अपकमिंग सेशन और क्लास और कोर्स. So, हमेशा याद रखें कि स्टूडेंट फेसिंग AI प्लस डैशबोर्ड इज नॉट इक्वल टू टीचर फेसिंग AI. टीचर के एंड पे जो रिक्वायरमेंट्स हैं एंड द एक्टिविटीज विच यू हैव टू डू आर डिफरेंट देन व्हाट इज एट द स्टूडेंट एंड. जी, तो ट्रेडिशनल असेसमेंट क्या करती है? ट्रेडिशनल असेसमेंट ये करती है कि हर बच्चे को आप एक ही स्टैंडर्डाइज जगह से गुजारने की कोशिश कर रहे हैं. जब हम ये नहीं कर पाते तो हम ये करते हैं, एक बच्चा जो अपनी curiosity, individuality, creativeness के साथ हमारे पास आता है, हम उसको chop off करके एक system के एन मुताबिक एंड perfect to the fit for the system बना देते हैं. यही करते हैं ना? आपका ख्याल है कि ये चलेगा ये for the next few years? No. So, stop and test assessments. Those are not rigorously evaluating your students' understanding of a topic. Use AI. AI for what? AI for automated continuous assessment. It gives you constant feedback as a teacher, as a student, as a parent about how the student learns, what kind of support they need, and the progress they are making towards their learning goals. So, this is the future of educational advancement based on AI. Modernized student experience and engagement, AI assistants, hyper individualization and personalization, automated operations, adaptive learning, content delivery at their own pace, conversational interfaces, content localization, innovation, and competitive advantages. These are some of the future directions of educational advancement in AI. So future of AI in education is related to impact. The major impact is going to happen through AI. The potential is to transform the education for good, but there is a negative element also, so you need to be careful about it. If you know some negative minded people, they get expertise in AI, they can misuse it. So as educators, learning scientists, and policy makers, you must engage with computer scientists and AI developers so that you can create that AI in the way you like it, on you like you in the way you want to make it forward according to the real need and according to the demands, so that you can address for common good. Conclusion, jiska sabko intezar hai ji, AI ke bare mein ye hai ki it is the convergence of emerging technologies, and being an educator, I have changed it a little bit. I've said AI in education is a convergence of emerging educational technologies. Convergence kya hoti hai? Bahut sari directions se ek focus, ek jagah pe focus kar rahe hain. But we need to steer this revolution in the right direction so that we can improve likelihood, to reduce inequality, to promote a fair and inclusive globalization. And by the way, UNESCO is doing a great job in promoting AI in education. So last thing, global education and education for all is only possible if we learn about AI in education. So special thanks for Dr. Wynne-Holmes from University of College London and UNESCO consultant for helping me learn about the AI. So I've been putting so much questions. Achha, AI ye bhi kar sakta hai, to kaise kar sakta hai AI? Kis direction mein ja raha hai, what would the future of AI? So he'll be helping some of the material of these slides. Those have been taken from his slides. So thank you so much, and I'm open for the question answer session. Ji, any question from the audience? Ji.
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam.
My name is Dr. Mohammad Shkil. I'm from Economics Department. As you stated that AI would be used in future, and we are currently using its early versions.
Yes.
My question is related to the cognitive abilities of the students.
Mm-hmm.
That what is the role of psychological or cognitive capabilities of students in continuous AI assessment? That is, psychological studies suggest some limitations of human brain in involvement. So in the context ke wo ek machine hai AI, वो तो कंटिन्यूसली वो करेंगे और असेसमेंट करेंगे, लेकिन ह्यूमन कैपेबिलिटीज उन सवालात को आंसर करने की लिमिटेड है, कॉग्निटिव एबिलिटी लिमिटेड है, और एआई वो अनलिमिटेड है, उसमें जो भी फीड किया वो उसको कर सकते हैं, लेकिन ह्यूमन ब्रेन एक लिमिट में ही वर्क करता है। इसको हम किसी तरह से भी कोई इंजेक्शन लेकर तो हम अपने आप को एआई के बराबर लेकर नहीं जा सकते। इन कंटिन्यूस एआई असेसमेंट वो तो इसी तरह से ही वो असेस करेगा ना स्टूडेंट्स को कि उनकी कैपेबिलिटी एक जैसी है, जबकि हम बात कर रहे हैं कि वो कैपेबिलिटी में डिफरेंट हैं, तो वो चीज कैसे इनकॉर्पोरेट की जा सकती है, ये सवाल है मेरा।
देखिए, एक चीज मैं हमेशा स्टूडेंट को कहती हूँ कि एआई इज अ मशीन और इट वर्क्स ऑन गार्बेज इन गार्बेज आउट। ये टीचर ने बताना है कि उसने क्या असेस करना है, कौन कौन से स्टेप असेस करने हैं। आपकी मशीन आपको हेल्प कर रही है टू मेक इट ऑटोमेटेड। So to design what AI is going to do, that is the task of the teacher. What is going to be assessed, how it is going to be assessed, and believe you me, you are not going to assess your students for the first three levels of Bloom's taxonomy. Maybe the third level you may can use it, but ab everything is on the fingertip of a student. You cannot just ask, hey, what is that? Please define this. Do you know about that? These are the obsolete questions. You have to move forward on the Bloom's taxonomy upward. You have to have, you know, questions. Those create their you know, critical and creative thinking. Don't activate those, their critical and creative thinking. So you may ask them to please design something out of this content.
अच्छा मैडम, यहाँ पे जो मेरा पॉइंट है, जो मेरे जहन में आ रहा है, देखिए अल्टीमेटली हमने स्टूडेंट्स को बेसिक कंसेप्ट तो सिखाना है,
बिल्कुल,
और वो सिखाना है तो उसको पूछने के लिए वो ट्रेडिशनल क्वेश्चंस पूछने पड़ेंगे कि क्या उसको बेसिक की भी समझ है या वो जो सेकेंडरी टूल्स हैं और उसने इंटरनेट के वेब के जरिए से वो देख के जवाब दे, क्या वो सीख रहा है?
वो पूछने की जरूरत नहीं है. दोज आर एम्बेडेड इन योर हायर ऑर्डर लेवल असेसमेंट. अनलेस और अंटिल अ स्टूडेंट विल कवर द लोअर लेवल्स, he will not reach up to the higher level.
तो फिर जी, तो फिर यहाँ पे जो diversification की आपने शुरू में बात की पिछले जो session था, कि student diversified होते हैं अपनी capabilities के अंदर, तो वो चीज फिर कैसे incorporate होगी? यानी यहाँ पे traditional को हम बिल्कुल अगर rule out कर देते हैं तो वो इतना अच्छा नहीं होगा, especially वो जो कि जिनकी IQ level relatively low है, और हम इस reality को rule out नहीं कर सकते कि एक अच्छा पढ़ने वाला बच्चा होता है, एक कम उसके यानी जो उसकी कैटेगरीज है, जैसे ब्लू टैक्सोनॉमी भी उस चीज को हाईलाइट, तो हम बिल्कुल रूल आउट नहीं कर सकते. हमने उस बच्चे को भी साथ लेकर चलना है जो जिसका आईक्यू लेवल बहुत लो है, तो उस कॉन्टेक्स्ट में ट्रेडिशनल को हम बिल्कुल इग्नोर करना.
मुराद देखिए, मेरी बात सुने, मैं डॉक्टर साजिद आपको मौका देती हूँ. डॉक्टर साजिद हमारे स्पेशलिस्ट हैं इस चीज में. एक चीज सिंपल सी बात है कि जो बोरिंग टीचर होता है ना, वो इलेक्ट्रॉनिकली भी यूज कर ले कॉन्टेंट, वो बोरिंग ही होता है. वो क्या करेगा? वो करेगा स्टैमर मॉडल का सब्स्टिट्यूशन लेवल. स्टैमर मॉडल एक इंटीग्रेशन, टेक्नोलॉजी इंटीग्रेशन का मॉडल है, जिसमें कहा जाता है पहला लेवल ये है कि जो आप बगैर इलेक्ट्रॉनिक डिवाइस के कर रहे थे, वो अब आप इलेक्ट्रॉनिक डिवाइस कर रहे हैं. मिसाल के तौर पे आपने खत लिखा किसी शख्स को, अब आप टाइप कर रहे हैं वर्ड पे. वो डिफरेंस है, प्रोसेस में कोई चेंज नहीं है, सिर्फ आप टूल यूज कर रहे हैं. तो अनफॉर्चुनेटली Most of our teachers are at that level. हम ये कह रहे हैं प्रोसेस ही ऑल टुगेदर चेंज हो गया. अब आप कह रहे हैं स्टूडेंट्स को कि खत नहीं लिखना, अब स्टोरी बनाओ जिसमें आपने वो पॉइंट्स असेस करने हैं, उसको अपने बाकी क्लास वालों के साथ शेयर करो यूजिंग वेब 2.0 टूल्स, एंड उसकी फॉर्मेट चेंज हो गया. नो मोर टेक्सचुअल डेटा, ओनली टेक्सचुअल डेटा इज देयर, बट दैट देयर आर अदर आर्टिफैक्ट्स ऑल्सो. तो ये दैट ऑल डिपेंड्स ऑन द टीचर हाउ टू यूज द टेक्नोलॉजी. टेक्नोलॉजी इटसेल्फ हैज नो ब्रेन. अच्छा, अब मैं आपको इसकी एक और छोटी सी मिसाल ही देती हूँ. ऑटोनॉमस कार में क्या होता है? ऑटोनॉमस कार में ये होता है कि पहले मैं एज अ ड्राइवर कंप्यूटर के साथ बैठूंगी और मैं उसको ट्रेन करूंगी. तो आई यूज, यू नो, एक होता है ट्रेनिंग डेटा. तो ट्रेन कर रही हूँ, मैं ड्राइव कर रही हूँ, साथ कंप्यूटर लर्न कर रहा है कि कितने डिस्टेंस पे जाके मैंने कौन सा टर्न कैसे लेना है, कब ब्रेक लगानी है, ये सारा कुछ लर्न कर रहा है. फिर आ जाता है टेस्टिंग फेज, और फिर जाके आपके पास टेस्ला की गाड़ी आती है जो कि ड्राइवर लेस होती है. इट इज नॉट समथिंग कि उसने बगैर ट्रेनिंग के आपको वो कंप्यूटर ने वो सारा कुछ दूर. इट्स ऑल अबाउट ट्रेनिंग द कंप्यूटर. सो हाउ गुड यू ट्रेन अ कंप्यूटर, दैट विल हेल्प यू टू रेप्लीकेट योर कॉग्निटिव प्रोसेसेस.
ओके मैम, और सेकंड ये मैं ऐड करना चाहूंगा कि ऑफ कोर्स जब ये हमारा पैराडाइम शिफ्ट है तो डायनामिक्स हैं, और उसमें चीजें फिर आहिस्ता आहिस्ता अपडेट, जब इक्विलिब्रियम आ जाएगा लॉन्ग रन के अंदर, तो हम इन जो क्वेरीज हैं एक्चुअली हम उनको रिजॉल्व कर चुके होंगे. लेकिन हम उस स्टेज पे हैं जहां पे कुछ पॉइंट्स जो है उनको हाईलाइट करने की जरूरत है, क्योंकि ये स्टूडेंट कॉन्टेक्स्ट में है, तो स्टूडेंट के आईक्यू के हवाले से मैंने उस चीज को हाईलाइट करने की कोशिश.
मेरा अपना बड़ा स्ट्रांग बिलीव है एज अ एजुकेटर एंड रिसर्चर कि अनलेस और अनटिल यू पुट योर स्टूडेंट्स इन अ ग्रैपलिंग सिचुएशन, दे डोंट लर्न. डोंट मेक थिंग्स इजी फॉर देम, बट इफ यू आर मेकिंग थिंग्स डिफिकल्ट फॉर देम, प्लीज गिव यू नो द सपोर्ट एज वेल. तो इस पूरे सेशन का मकसद ये था कि आपके दिमागों में कुछ सवाल पैदा करने. आई होप के बहुत सारे सवाल आए होंगे, एंड दिस वॉज द एक्चुअल target of this session. Ji.
Okay, ma'am. I'm Imran from English department. My question from your session and from your previous session and various theories, we are making questions applying Bloom's taxonomy and question banks. So many questions we form. My question is, there is always, it is said and repeatedly said, it's a cliche that there is always gap between theory and practice. So so many theories we have seen in your slides, so again and again. So my question is, when you go for application as a researcher, as a teacher, do you see any kind of gap between these theories and the application of these theories and the results students are giving? I want to know about the thing, the gap.
Actually, जो मैंने आपके साथ second part share किया है, that is telling about some of the emerging trends. Those were the things which I have been using in my own classes. So I wish that we could have an interface जिसमें आप लोग computer पे बैठे होते और मैं आपको बताती कि how to do it. So you definitely we are constrained with that. लेकिन what I used to do, I used to have online sessions also for teaching you those techniques and using it in the classroom. तो यहाँ जो अभी हमारा सेशन था इसका मकसद था टू गिव यू एन एक्सपोजर ऑफ व्हाट इज हैपनिंग इन द आउटर वर्ल्ड एंड द नेक्स्ट स्टेप इज टू मेक यू लर्न अबाउट इट. तो मैंने अभी आपको जस्ट एक वो फ्लेवर दिया है कि दीज थिंग्स एग्जिस्ट एंड आई हैव बीन यूजिंग दोज इन माय ओन क्लासरूम्स एंड आई हैव बीन हैविंग अ फेयर डेटा डिफेंसिबल डेटा एंड इंटरप्रिटेशन एंड दोज आर ऑल वर्केबल. डिपेंड करता है कि यू नीड टू ट्राई. देर इज नो वन सोल्यूशन फिट ऑल. ओके, रिमेंबर दैट. एज अ टीचर यू शुड हैव अ टूल बॉक्स इन विच यू नीड टू हैव सो मेनी टूल्स इन टर्म्स ऑफ टीचिंग, इन टर्म्स ऑफ डिफरेंट यूजिंग, इन टर्म्स ऑफ असेसमेंट टूल्स एंड ऑल दैट. एंड वेन एवर यू फील लाइक के इन दिस पर्टिकुलर सिचुएशन इन अ क्लासरूम the current tool is not working well, so I need to have another tool and try it. And believe you me, sometimes it doesn't work. It is not like a magic that you are using a tool and you are getting the results which you are expecting. Sometimes you get so many unexpected outcomes. But this is the way you learn. You need to keep on using different tools. And I have learned this way. And there is no other way to make you learn, because every teacher is different. Like every learner is different, every teacher is also different. So we do have our own teaching styles as well. So you need to keep on checking what are the new methods, those are coming up, how can I use it, try to use it, and then keep on using that work. This is how it happens. There is no ready-made solution that you can just pick and implement in your class. So you need to have a very hard work. Like ye jo maine presentation aapke liye samne aayi hai, this is the work of about 1.5 weeks. So to tell you one slide, to share one slide content, I have to study. And this is what you need to inculcate in your students and your teachers as well. This teaching is not meant for ki ji mujhe aata hai and I am very smart at that. No, teaching is about updating your knowledge. Do you have the updated knowledge? And if you don't have the updated knowledge, then you have to go back and sirf knowledge nahi, you need to update your skills as well. So aapka jawab ye hai ki theory ko practice mein aane mein time lagta hai, lekin तब वो थ्योरी प्रैक्टिस में आएगी जब आप उसको यूज करेंगे. मैं आपको बता रही हूँ, मैं मलेशिया में 3.5 साल रही हूँ एंड आई जस्ट गॉट डिफरेंट आइडियाज फ्रॉम हेयर फ्रॉम देयर, अटेंडेड फ्यू वर्कशॉप्स, गॉट न्यू आइडियाज एंड आई ट्राइड सम एंड सम ऑफ देम वर्क वेल, सम ऑफ देम डिड नॉट वर्क वेल. सो आई नीड टू कीप ऑन लर्निंग न्यू थिंग्स. दैट इज कॉल्ड ग्रोथ माइंडसेट. And that is need to be inculcated in our teachers as well. Agar mera ek course jo maine pichle saal padhaya, naye course se at least 40% different nahi hai, so it's a point of concern for me. At least caring 40% need to be updated. So this is the matter of learning. Agar aap evil purpose ke liye use karenge, to obviously humko pata hai ki negative cheezon ke liye bhi यूज हो सकता है. तो कीपिंग इन व्यू दैट कि उसको नेगेटिवली यूज ना किया जाए, अनफेयर मीन्स के लिए यूज ना किया जाए. जैसे कि अभी भी वी आर स्ट्रगलिंग विद सम एथिकल इश्यूज रिलेटेड टू एआई. जैसे फॉर एग्जांपल, अगर ड्राइवरलेस कार अगर किसी को हिट करती है और कोई एक्सीडेंट होता है, तो किसके खिलाफ पर्चा कटेगा, किसके खिलाफ कार्रवाई होगी. सो दीज आर द एथिकल इश्यूज वी आर स्टिल स्ट्रगलिंग इन दैट. एंड दैट देयर कम्स द थर्ड कैटेगरी. रिमेंबर आई हैव टोल्ड यू दैट देयर आर थ्री कैटेगरीज. वन इज लर्निंग विद एआई और लर्निंग फॉर एआई, और एक थी प्रिपेयरिंग योरसेल्फ फॉर एआई. तो वी आर स्टिल स्ट्रगलिंग इन दैट, क्योंकि एथिकल जो उसके डायलेमास हैं, वी नीड टू डील विद दैट. थैंक यू.